boy, we're bursting at the seams. We do not have enough room for all the students who need or want to take our courses. Come look at our facilities. They're embarrassing. They are literally embarrassing. I give tours to high school students who come here looking to come to UW-Madison, and they're looking at a lot of other good schools, and I take them for a tour around the building and have to show them these labs and our lecture halls, and they're looking at that and comparing that when they're deciding where to come.
Here we are at the flagship campus of the institution. They come to what should be a premier enterprise, and they're experiencing something that's really 40 years old. And that just doesn't convey what my colleagues and I understand about the excitement of modern science, but it's kind of hard to convey that in these laboratories that really have been untouched since the time of their original construction 40 to 50 years ago.
You need something stronger than that. They do the best they can with the facilities they have.
And it got a little bit darker.
Yeah, it got like a little.
I think that at a university like this, that it's a shame that they are not as good as when I've taught at community colleges and other smaller universities.
A copper chloride hydrate, and also safety for the students, where they're bumping into each other when they're trying to get by and get reagents or other chemicals. Compared to my undergrad university, they definitely are below par for what I've seen or other facilities that I've been at.
And we have excellent staff and excellent instructors. You know, we're making the most of what we have, but we are limited. We're limited, we can't continue the enrollment growth that we've been seeing the last couple years.
Our department is world-class in research. It's world-class in research related to chemistry education. Yet, we don't have the facilities to implement the very techniques that are developed in this department.
And when it boils, it will be 100 degrees.
Our concept of the new building is that it needs to be flexible and adaptable to last 50 or 100 years. So with the ability to handle the number of students, we also have a tremendous opportunity to adapt our curriculum to much more modern techniques.
And then put the test tube in the hot water.
If the new building project doesn't go through, we are at our limit. We cannot accommodate more students, and I don't think we can continue to attract the level of students that we've been attracting.
We just are in desperate need of new facilities and more flexibility to be able to deliver good curriculum on behalf of the students of the state of Wisconsin.
KC and KP.